we'll let you go and have a look over here. There's a young girl over here. She might have been left behind by her friends. She's feeling a bit lost. She might need some sort of assistance. Just go and see if she's okay. Hello, love. Hi there. She's very quiet. Oh, are you all right? I guess that's a no. I mean, yeah, this is very unusual. I mean, that's a lot to come out of quite a small person. I think she's clearly quite unwell. I mean, we want to know what's happened to her tonight and what's made her vomit like this. Get it out. Get it over that way is better. Get it all out. I'm going to request for assistance. Mano, requesting assistance over here.
Copy, O'Leary. What's your location?
I'm right behind you.
Trampling.
Yeah, we've got to get this girl to her caregivers. She's really unwell.
What's your name, love?
Bazuwal of the Unholy Realm.
We've got B, I've got B, A.
Bazuwal of the Unholy Realm.
Okay.
As members of the New Zealand Police Force, it's our job to offer support to those in need, and that takes the support and the respect of the community.
Absolutely. It really does.
Is that the Unholy Realm in Haitaitai?
Officer down!
I've got an officer down.
Officer back up.
He's back up. That was a bit uncalled for. Comms, we're bringing in a juvenile female for drunk and disorderly and charging her with throwing a police officer. Over.
Do you know how to turn the aircon off in the back?
The aircon is off.
Hmm?
Big night Saturday night, a lot of people out drinking, but you guys are out there doing some exemplary police work. Savelli and Jones apprehended a vandal caught in the act of defacing public property. The man was drawing a large penis on a wall. They managed to confiscate the pen and change the drawing into that of a man with a big nose. Actually, looking at it now, it's not really gender specific, is it? It showed initiative, so well done. What else? Five of the seven pairs of trousers that went missing from Blakefield Menswear on Lambton Quay were retrieved. Well done, Stevenson and Parker. Hold on. Parker, those aren't uniform pants, are they?
There must have been a mix-up, sir.
Is that right? Is that right, Parker? Those are Blakefield Menswear pants, Parker. They're not standard police issue, are they? And where is Stevenson today, Parker?
At home on Trade Me.
Why?
Selling pants.
Right. Might have to have a little discussion about this later in my office, yeah?
I'll do a report.
Good. Let's get back out there, guys, and remember to be safe. Okay? Dismissed.
Thank you.
Minogue, O'Leary, I want to talk to you guys about your report. What I'm about to show you is top secret. Don't look. I have security access, a special PIN number.
5.
Hey, Sarge, you sure have some more digits in your PIN?
What, like PIN numbers?
Well, like anyone has a 1 in 10 chance of guessing that.
Oh, yeah, of course. But there's more numbers involved. Beep, 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 beep.
What is it?
What you're about to see behind this door is classified. Welcome to the Wellington Police Paranormal Unit. You are the only two officers to have set foot in this division.
Because of its classified nature?
No, I've invited other officers in here and no one wants to come in here. This is where I file anything unusual, anything out of the ordinary that defies worldly explanation. Do you believe in ghosts?
Not really.
My brother drew that when he was 10.
He saw it in our bathroom. I believe this is a UFO.
I believe it's a hubcap.
Interested in what you think, Minogue?
Yeah, I believe it's a hubcap.
Yeah, well, I don't care what you guys think. This is the file that pertains to your case. This is a report from 1951. The felon spewed gallons of sulfuric vomit smelling like eggs or Rotorua. This is from 1885. The lady spoke with a voice by standards described as that of a coarse gentleman. She expelled fervent and copious bile, its odour, that of sulphur.
Well, that's exactly what happened tonight.
Now, the name the assailant gave in each case was Bazual of the Unholy Realm.
Are you joking with us?
I don't joke at work. Outside of work, I have a observational, absurdist sense of humour, sometimes even a little bit risque. Sorry about that.
Look, I don't give a shit. Are you trying to say that these cases are linked?
In each of the previous cases, the person claimed to be Bazual performed a human sacrifice at dawn.
I'm just thinking maybe we'd be better off, you know, doing something similar to the pants, looking for the pants. We could be out there on the streets, you know, during the daytime.
I'm actually rostered on. It's my turn to get attacked by the police dog.
Get down to that interrogation room and check out this Bazual character right now.
Yep, okay.
And I'm going to stay here and change the PIN number.
Yes, sir.
Dismissed.
So we've just been reassigned to the Wellington Paranormal Unit. It's a highly classified unit.
Yeah.
So, yes.
It's top secret. No one else knows about it. It's Aphelion Jones. They haven't been briefed on it yet. I mean, to put it in layman's terms, we're kind of like Mulder and Scully. She's like Scully because she's analytical. She's got the brains. And I'm a man with brown hair.
So, I mean, I'm not sure if paranormal phenomena exists.
It's pronounced phenomena.
It's phenomena.
It's phenomena.
Phenomena.
Another way that we like Mulder and Scully is that we've got sort of an underlying sexual tension going on. Eh? She doesn't look well.
The dead shall rise from hell.
Lozenge, maybe we could call her. Do you want us
to call your parents or a guardian parent?
There will be buckets of blood and a fountain of fire.
Is she scaring me, O'Leary? Can you do your bad cop?
Stop that. It's a bit scary.
My name is Sergeant Marker. I'd like to have a few words with you, if I may.
Can I call my parents?
She's just got a normal voice. I thought you said she had some kind of demonic man's voice.
Yeah, well, she did before.
Can I go home now?
She just seems like a normal teenage girl. This is not a case for the paranormal unit at all. I had a whole speech plan and everything. What am I going to do now? Look, I'm very sorry about this.
I tell you what, we'll contact your parents. We'll come and get you. Hey, whoa.
Jump after it. That was pretty tame. I mean, have you seen the likes of that before?
Have I seen that before? Have I seen a teenage girl leap through a window
have light going all over her face and her hair blowing back in the wind. No. No, I haven't. And I'll tell you what it is. It's pretty obvious to me.
Drugs.
I thought robot.
B4, this is comms. Over.
Go ahead.
Domestic dispute at 9 Grays Ave. Need you to respond. Over.
Yeah, that's a negative comms. We're on a special mission. Over.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the caller has requested Monoghan O'Leary specifically. Over.
On our way. Over.
Do we get to turn the lights on for that?
Yeah, definitely.
I might go a bit faster if that's right.
Well, we need to. We've got to get there. Comms has said. So we're on the way to a domestic incident. Hopefully it's just an argument, something to resolve quickly because we've got obviously other things to do, potentially bigger fish to fry. Good evening. Hi, Officers O'Leary and Minogue.
Has there been some trouble? I've locked in the garage.
Okay, we should probably come in and have a look around. And
yeah, come in.
That's okay.
He's watching the rugby and he starts yelling and carrying on like he's possessed.
It's just the worst midlife crisis you've ever seen.
Minogue.
Oh, matching shirts, that's awesome. We could do that.
We do that every day. It's not that look, it's the same girl.
Ah. She looks a million times better in the photo, eh, than in person.
Don't say that, you're running up.
At one time, he was very normal.
What is normal?
Well, this isn't.
Okay. Oh. Yeah, that's more in a midlife crisis.
Oh. Gary, can you get down off the roof? The cops are here.
He's breaking the law of gravity, O'Leary.
How did you get up there, sir?
Minogue and O'Leary, we meet again.
I don't think so, mate. Do you know my name?
Do you play softball?
I am Bazooab.
Bullshit, his name's Gary.
I am Bazooab of the Unholy Realm.
Hey, look, just try and calm yourself, mate.
You should probably come down from there, mate.
He got really angry when our daughter came home late and she was in a really bad mood. I mean, I don't know, could have been too much screen time.
Do you want some help?
Oh, no. Look, your neck is going to get really sore and I'm not massaging it tonight.
Have you seen that before?
God, no.
You need to stop that and you really need to listen to your wife, Gary.
You're 47.
47?
Are you alright? You're feeling a bit better?
Hmm. What am I doing on the fridge?
Yeah, so the gentleman calmed down, so we've just let him off with a warning.
Hmm. Turns out he was a different Bazooal. Our original person of interest was his daughter. And it turns out that she's seems sort of calmed down now as well, so a bit of a win-win.
I mean, so we can go now, knowing that everyone here's safe.
Mm, mm.
Well, so the father and daughter both called themselves Bazooal of the Unholy Realm.
Yeah, he's named after her.
And then they both had super strength.
Weird.
And talked about fountains of fire.
I think it runs in the family. Speaking of running the family.
We're going 50. Just gone into those bushes.
See you on foot.
You're slowing down, O'Leary.
In pursuit! I'll follow her! Hit her off! Ma'am! I need some places of defence! Stop! I'm gonna have to scale the fence. That's right. Let's get this up here. Stop. Why don't you get your feet in?
Ma'am! Ma'am! Shouldn't be running to the playground, ma'am! I've got some questions. Ooh! Ooh! Ma'am? You shouldn't be running to the playground in those old boots.
So I've been in pursuit of a highly acrobatic housewife.
Ma'am?
Just come through the children's playground through the back here and she's absolutely vanished. No idea where she could have gone. I'm in two minds about whether I really want to find her, to be honest.
Hello?
Minogue.
Who said that?
Oh, g'day, boy. Hello?
Hello, Minogue. Your mother sucks dicks in hell, Minogue.
You're a bad dog.
The mouth will open. The dead will
stop
walk.
Stop talking, you freaky little dog.
I am Bazooal. I do as I please. There will be buckets of blood. A fountain of fire.
Did you guys see that? Dog was talking, right?
Well, obviously you do get hurdles in policing, and these sorts of fences are certainly one of them. You know, it's a real challenge. I think certainly since they've changed the way they make these fences, it's been a lot harder to get over them cleanly. It's not something that normally happens to me. To be honest, if anything, Minogue perhaps is a little bit more prone to this kind of thing. But like I said, I was just giving them my best shot, and it didn't quite work out on the day. Yeah. Minogue, I'm just requesting assistance here.
Caught on a fence again, O'Leary.
Yep.
On my way. I think I need a hug.
So a dog spoke to you?
Yes, and it was very rude.
You sure wasn't like one of those internet dogs that sounds like it's talking when it's actually just barking?
Like a rogue? No.
Rogue?
I'm not an idiot.
Maybe somebody was behind the dog while it was chewing quietly?
No, it was saying that my mother does sexual stuff, and hell, these guys recorded all of it.
Do you mind if we get that footage?
What, of his mum?
No, of the dog.
He said his name was Bazawal.
I've been doing some extensive research on this Bazawal. I googled it. Turns out Bazawal means he who brings hell on earth.
Bazawal itself is not that great, but I mean, with that definition, it's not going to top any baby
names. I'm surprised it's so popular already.
It's not that the girl or the father or the dog have their name. It's the same entity, okay? It transfers from body to body, using them as vessels.
Huh?
So the two of you picked up the young woman here and then brought her to the station, which is here. She escaped and ran to this address here. It transferred to the father and then to the wife, who ran to here, changed course to here, and then turned around and then came back to this point here, where Minogue had the conversation with the dog.
So it's kind of like one of those stars you used to draw in primary school.
Yeah.
Remember those?
I saw those other lines confused it.
You mean the map lines? Sorry, Sarge, yep.
What it is a pentagram. It's a symbol of the devil.
Oh.
It's centered right here in Cuba Mall. In the mid-60s, a group of Satanists based in the Wellington CBD erected a shrine to hell itself.
That dog kept on saying, buckets of blood, a fountain of fire.
We're not talking about the dog right now, we're talking about this, one of Wellington's most iconic monuments. That's the Cuba Street Bucket Fountain.
These 13 buckets represent the 13 chambers of hell. The fountain itself is a hell mouth, a gateway to and from the underworld.
The mouth shall open, we dead shall walk the earth.
Metallica.
No, it's that dog. Oh. That dog was saying it. Could that be relevant?
Bazawal intends to make a human sacrifice. If he succeeds, the dead will claw their way up from hell through this bucket fountain and walk the streets of the Wellington CBD.
Sarge, I think the bucket just tipped blood.
It's begun.
What's happening, guys?
We're trying to stop the dead from walking through Cuba Street, Parker. Parker, your pants.
O'Leary reckons there's going to be blood coming out of the fountain.
Okay, look, it's going to tip. Now.
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 No.
Now.
No.
Now.
No.
Now.
Damn it.
Now.
Now.
No. No, it's that horrible.
It is blood.
It's a sign of the apocalypse.
It's blood.
Minogue, is that the dog you saw?
Minogue.
It's got the same voice.
Right, let's get it.
No. It called for me. You're a bad dog. You're a naughty little dirty mouth dog. You stay. Stay. I got it, guys. It's all good, guys.
Tell us what you want, Demon. Tell us right now.
Answer.
Dead shall walk the earth.
Transfer to that guy.
Yeah.
Requesting assistance.
Clearance to taser? No. I'll tase him.
No, we must perform an exorcism.
Do you know how to do that?
An exorcism. So what you're going to need is a crucifix.
Yep, check.
A holy Bible.
Got it.
And some duct tape.
Oh, guys.
Pretty urgent now, I think.
Do I go into hell, my
know? The power of Christ compels you.
The power of Christ compels you.
What next, Ed?
I don't know. It's buffering. I'm sorry, guys. I'm on prepay.
Fountain's on burning. It's burning.
Call the fire service.
You are the sacrifice to the Dark Lord.
Why me?
Well, Abby, they always sacrifice virgins, mate. So are you a virgin?
No.
Well, sorry, I don't know the sexual. I don't know your sexual history.
I've actually never seen any of his girlfriends. He might actually be a virgin.
Hey, Leary.
May you say this 3 times.
Okay, say it 2 more times.
The power of Christ compels you.
That's 2.
Authority.
The power of Christ compels you.
It's working. Square. Arrest him.
We're going to get you.
Wait. No. Get off him. Get off him. That is not Blazerwell. We banished him to hell, remember?
Oh, that's
right. Yeah, so we're not entirely sure what happened out here tonight, whether it was some sort of mass hysteria, it had been, some illegal drugs in the water supply.
Or it was paranormal for my mama.
Maybe. Certainly if you suspect that your friend or colleague or anyone that you know has been taken over by a demon from hell, that's the kind of thing you really want to, call in quickly.
Anytime there's gates to hell?
Never a good sign.
Give us a call.
What this incident highlighted is the need for a special unit of the New Zealand Police Force that deals with the cases which have no worldly explanation.
I was wondering where you got to, Parker. You're in luck, mate. In about 6 minutes, I'm off the clock. I have a legendary joke for you all. Well, I haven't actually told it yet.